I got an awesome question from Debbie. She saw this image that was changed to this image, and she said, "How did you do that, Janice?" I told her I use Gaussian blur. And she said, "I would really love a tutorial on how to do this. I'm having a lot of problems. Things are getting too mushy." So of course, you ask me questions, I will answer them via video. So let's get to it. I'm Janice Sullivan from Sullivan J Photography, and I help you get up close and personal with your camera. So, Debbie, we are going to dive in to Gaussian blur, but again, this technique that we're going to go into can be used with any type of blur that you choose. Lens blur, directional stuff for like the clouds, all kinds of fun stuff I've used it on. So Debbie, this is for you and for those of you guys that really want to push your creativity. We're going to dive into Photoshop and get to it.
In order to use Gaussian blur and not mess up your main focal point, you definitely have to use layers and masks. I'm going to share with you how to do this in Photoshop because most people have Adobe Photoshop. But if you have On One or something like that, as long as you can have layers and masks, you're good to go. The first thing that we need to do is make separate layers, two of them. So I'll just drag down here to the bottom, or you can do the Control or Command J, and that will copy your layer. We're going to rename these so we don't get confused, because Janice gets confused all the time. So that one's going to go ahead and we're going to put that one as blur. And then this one, I'm just going to say the main subject, and I'm going to say flower. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to select the flower. And you can use a variety of selection tools that you're used to doing. You just want to get kind of a rough draft. Now, I'm going to have a problem because see all the different colors, they all match. Of course, it's easier to select when you have colors that are totally different. We'll just go up here. Woo, it's going kind of crazy. We're going to fix this up. Now I have a selection. What I'm going to do is go to Layer, Layer Mask, Reveal Selection. And you'll see over here to the right that it has made a mask. I'm going to clean it up a little bit by double clicking it, and I'll click on the mask, select mask. And once I've gotten into the select mask area, this is where you can really hone in on your masking in Photoshop. So I'm going to change it to overlay. So this is my mask, and what I want to do is really clean it up. So I'll go ahead and just give this opacity a little bit. Hold an option. I'm just going to remove a lot of it because I put a little bit too much. I'm holding it down, as you can see. Next, what you want to do is you want to refine your mask and get it pretty good. So I'm going to click on the refine mask brush right here, and we are going to really hone in and clean all of this up so we have a really good brush, or a really good mask, I should say, not a brush. This brush is absolutely amazing. I love it. Take some time, put some music on. You really do need to pay attention to the details of the flower, because when you use a blur tool, you don't want to blur this. You really don't. You want it to be nice and sharp. That's what makes it fun. Command Z if you screw it up, which I always do. Now, one of the things that I like to do, especially if it's hard, I will feather it out a little bit, but I'll just show you the difference. Here it's smooth, but most of the time it's feather. And it just helps it not be so hard. Right here up at the top, there's a minus and plus. So here's the minus. If you want to take it away, you could do it that way. If you don't want to, I just use the keystrokes a lot. It just gets faster going back and forth. But this is where you can play with it. You do want to take your time and get a good mask, because you're going to be using this. And then I'll go ahead and push OK. Oh, it added an extra layer. I always have that automatically. When I do something like this, it adds another layer so I don't mess with things. You could see the mask here compared to the mask that I had before that I was working with. Look at how nice that looks. Down in here, it looks like I could mess with this a little bit better. So another way you can mess with this is make sure that you have, I have white revealed, you get your paintbrush, and I'm gonna go down X, and now it's black. And I wanna just fix this bottom part a little bit so it looks good. Because you've worked so hard on your mask, I really suggest that you do one more step. It's just one little extra step. Most of the time, you only have to do a little bit of things to the mask. The mask is really important. So uncheck your blur and your main layer, and you'll see here that we've got the image right here in our face. Click the Alt and Option and then on the mask, and now you're really seeing the mask up in details and really in your face. Now, if you see any other white spots or anything that's not, you know, very good when it comes to the mask, then it's time for you to clean it up a little bit. What you want to do, if you want to reveal more of your subject, you click here to get the white brush, and then you can start painting in some of the white if that's what you need to do. That's just like an extra tool that I think you should do. And most of the time, what it does is you'll see things that you've missed, and that's how you can fix it. So you just go back to the Alt and Option, you click off of it, and there is your flower. The next step you'll do once you have this awesome mask is click on the blur area. You're gonna make another selection. You're just gonna kind of go around it, around, around, around. And then you're gonna go ahead and go to Edit, Fill, and you will click, if you don't have it, Content Aware. Now what you'll do is if you click off the top layer, right? Now you see that you have an awesome background. So we will now go ahead and play with our actual blurs. So I'm going to use Gaussian for this one, but I will share some of the other fun blur tools that we have. We're going to go to Filter, and here's your blur. Another one is really fun to play with is your blur gallery, but let's go to Gaussian blur. In the Gaussian blur, you'll have this little pop-up. And here is where you can play the radius. Play with the radius. This is the image now, and then you can see I have 56 pixels, and it's really blurring it up. I mean, you could go really crazy if you want. See, here's really soft, which is actually really pretty, because I don't want to distract from my flower. So here's the preview, before and after, and we'll go ahead and push OK. Once you get the blur that you like, we'll go ahead and click on this top layer right here, and boom, we got this beautiful image that now you really could see. So here's the before, and it's kind of has the distraction of everything that's around it. So as we add the blur, we next add the next layer, and boom, look at how pretty that is.
If you have questions, ask down below in the comment section. And if you like the video, how about a thumbs up? I also have more tutorials on post-processing right down below, so check it out down here. And remember that 1,000 words does make a difference. I'm Jana Sullivan from Sullivan J Photography, and I help you get up close and personal with your camera. Have a great day. Cheers.